¡Hola, galera!
¡Yeah! ¡Bienvenidos!
Welcome, everyone, to a new episode of Sky Perth Talk. Rodrigo, how are you?
I'm doing great. How about you, Franco?
Oh, nice. Super excited to this new episode because we have so many news, right? Like public service announcement to do for the people?
Yeah, I think we kind of have like a groundbreaking, especially when you talk about drones and flying here in Australia, you know, that is not something that is all the time.
Yeah.
So we have a really good news for you guys that are FPV lovers, want to see something completely different, a new perspective when you talk about drones. What's the news, Franco?
We got the permit to fly FPV legally in Australia, but not just that, we have the permit to fly close to people. So we have now the possibility to do some amazing shots, completely legal with all the safety procedure, the checklist, the drone, the safety drone that we have, yeah. We built. So it's a huge news. And the most important thing is we are the first one in Australia.
That's a really good point because we do have now the instrument to fly EVLOS Class 1. Mm-hmm. So it means that we can fly drones, FPV drones, with one observer in our side, yeah, and the drone pilot. And also the second instrument that allows us to fly close to people, which is basically up to 1 meter, mm-hmm, of people, that give us freedom and ability and creativity to do something amazing and everything that our clients are asking. Do you remember how many projects that we lost because we didn't have this permit?
Exactly, which is totally, you know, you can understand what that happened because it's pretty brand, like it's a new niche that we are having. We see in the internet, we watch a lot of FPV videos around the world. Most of them, to be honest, are completely illegal, you know, drones flying over the people. So of course you have many people watching those videos and really want to get the same shot, maybe for advertisement, for promotional videos. And they try to hire someone to do that. But at the end you realize it's not possible because the regulations are not built for that. You know, they are not created for that. It's like a still working process,
yeah,
and we got this special permit, and that's why we are the first one.
And I think the beauty to have those permits now and those approvals, anytime that you have to fly FPV, we have to get the permit again and ask for a permit again for CASA, because there will be like a specific project,
yeah,
with specific client that we need to do this. And that is start to be really hard for us to discuss this, let's say, incremental,
yeah,
on the code. So we have like the code for us to fly the drone, plus you have the CASA fee,
yeah,
which is the assessment that they do for, yeah, all the applications. So they charge us like 5 hours, which is 5 times 160, 165,
yeah,
which, yeah, like or not, it's
their project almost is too much.
Exactly, yeah, it's almost like $1,000 just for, yeah, us to have assessment from CASA. So having these instruments on our side give this freedom and ability for us to not overcharge our clients. You can charge the fair amount for us to do the project.
Yeah.
And I think that's a really groundbreaking for us, and we can't wait to start work.
It reduced the cost for the client. It reduced the times, of course, the procedures that we have to do for make the project happen. So it's a huge news for everyone which is interested to hire those kind of services, of course, because this new announcement and this new opportunity for us, we are building specific drones to make those jobs even more safe. And we are following more procedures now. We are working together with a spotter. So it's like a new, maybe new way to offer drone services for the companies. And it's a huge market that we need to work on that. You know that the FPV, we need to have like a few drones of the same one just in case something happened, because they are custom built. We build them here in our houses. So it's really good. That's why, you know, all the custom features that those drones have, and it's really, really nice. And we can do those kind of big shots happen, you know?
Because this procedure is everything that we are going to be doing now. They're completely new for us. It's really good for us to start to use like the correct words for everything. Spotter is something that we use for when you are flying drones, like normal drones, and when you have like project that we are request permit for CASA, you need to do, like, for example, the airport, right? We recently shot like pretty much on the
inside of the airport.
Perth control tower.
Exactly.
So it was like, I don't know, 3 meters from them, right? So you're flying, we can show here with for you guys to show where we were flying.
Yeah.
But there we have to have at least like 2 or 3 spotters.
Yeah.
For FPV, the name is a little bit different. They are asking us to call observers.
Exactly.
That's a little bit different. And those guys, and honestly, it's not those guys, it's only one. So according with CASA, we only can have only one observer.
Mm-hmm.
And this observer, you'll be responsible to say for you, you can go right, you can go left, go down. Why do you think it's really important to have the observer? What is different from a normal spotter?
That's a good point, because many people, maybe we're talking about FPV, but many people in the other side of the screen, they don't know how is the procedure to get those kind of shots. And we are using every time these kind of goggles, so the FPV pilot needs to wear those goggles. So he's focused just to get the shot, watch what the drone is seeing through this small screen. So you can see in real time what the drone is live streaming for you, and you can maybe avoid obstacles, fly close to objects, do some risky shots, and you can be really, really focused because those kind of goggles that pretty much doesn't have any latency at all. So that's why it's really important to have someone next to you watching the surroundings, telling you if the drone is in the right path, or if you are going like close to something that you cannot see because you are wearing the goggles. So it's really nice to have like a person like you, Ron, in this case, watching the drone, because that's what you lose, right? You lose the perspective of the drone because you are watching the goggles.
Yep.
So you need someone else watching the drone.
Not necessarily the goggles. We are watching basically the camera that's in front of the drone,
exactly,
right?
Exactly.
And I think what you miss is what's happened on the sides.
Yeah.
What's happened underneath of the drone.
Exactly.
And hypothetically speaking, if you have to put the drone backwards, what's happened? What I can have here? Those drones doesn't have sensors or anything, right?
Or GPS even. So you need to like hold the position with your fingers every time. You don't have the automatic holding position, so it's everything manual. When you see a stop, you know, I need to keep the stick to stop the drone in the center. It's nothing automatically, it's everything manual. So that's why it's pretty complex to manage to fly those drones. Uh-huh. So it's really important to have someone else next to you, checking everything.
And talking about what are the advantages, for example, for our clients to use FPV drones?
Yeah.
Why do you think that's a groundbreaking for us to offer this kind of software to them?
Of course, we want to talk maybe more deep in the future about the different industries that we can work with. But I think for the sport industry to get some dynamic and action shots is really important. If also when the clients want to do some indoors tours or something in, you know, tight spaces, confined spaces, those small drones that they are really well protected, they are really nice, and we can make that happen.
Mm-hmm.
So our possibilities is pretty much without limits. We can fly everywhere.
And when you say like flying confined places, everything,
do you
remember that video that a guy in US, he shot inside of the bowling? I think it could be shown here, but that's the kind of perspective
Exactly.
It's completely different than everyone have seen so far, right?
What is becoming really popular the last 2-3 years is to watch and see those kind of continuous shots that maybe before was so hard to get that because you have to work so much in post-production, even to do the pre-production of the project, to see where you're going to do the cuts, if you're going to be filming indoors with cameras and then do a transition and go with the drone outside. So with those kind of FPV drones, you can get the one shot, you know, in only one take. And it's really good because you can plan the flight path and from the start to finish, fly just one battery with the drone and get the shot than the continuous shot.
The other use of the drones, especially we've been seeing a lot and watching a lot recently, is the introduction of the drones on cinema.
Oh yeah.
On films.
Yeah.
So exactly. One really good case is the ambulance.
Ambulance,
right?
Yeah, exactly.
So the ambulance, there are so many takes and so many use of the FPV drones that gave like a complete different view and a different perspective that not a normal camera couldn't do. A helicopter, it couldn't do as well. And also small drones, the drones that we use, they couldn't give the same perspective, right?
Exactly. That's why it's really important to, because let's be honest, Rob, it was so hard to even introduce ourselves a couple of years ago about in this world because we say, but like a Mavic or even of course an Inspire has a really nice quality. Those FPV never gonna get the same quality or similar. So, you know, we keep a little bit of distance a few years ago, but then realized that the FPV came here not to replace something, but to add like more maybe action movement, dynamic shots, and like it's a complement to the big Inspires with the big cinema cameras.
Yeah.
Even as you mentioned before, and now the cinema industry is building those specific drones, bigger FPV drones, where they put cinema cameras on top. Yeah. So in that case, you have amazing flight, amazing quality. But at the end of the day, it's just a tool that to improve what, you know, exists before. So it's,
I think the first film that I watched and it blew my mind every time that I saw that and I said how they did that and I realized it was from an FPV.
Yeah.
Was the film called Red Notice.
Yeah.
I don't know if you watch it.
Yeah.
It's basically the guy is flying, they are chasing the car, and
exactly.
After when the actor leaves,
yeah,
and they continue the shots, everything with the same camera, I don't know, that was amazing. I never saw the BTS about that,
exactly.
But we can definitely show how the final result.
Yeah, exactly. That is unbelievable. Yes, so many stuff, and of course we are every day working on it, see how we can implement those kind of drones and shots in different industries. We talk about a lot about sports, action shots for action movies, but we are trying and improving, trying some new stuff for tourism stuff as well, which is really nice to showcase the places in different ways. If you want to do something more dynamic or with more movement, maybe a FPV drone is going to be really nice to mix with professional cameras, professional drones, and get some tourism stuff really nice as well. So we are working on it and we try to give like a really nice result for the clients, right?
And I think that's the way that we are planning to go, and we are changing the drones that we are doing. We have like other day you built like a drone from, I don't know,
really?
200 grams or
yeah,
less than 200 grams. And now thinking to put like cinema cameras on drones. So we are changing a few things and we are already offering, and there are some projects already on.
Yeah. That's right.
On the queue, so we can shoot these and soon show to our
yeah. Also, the clients maybe is wondering how those drones perform. Of they are safety, as we say before, they are pretty pretty safe. We build them with some protective ducts like around the props.
Mm-hmm.
So if it bounces or hits something, it's not gonna break anything.
Yeah.
And it's going to be really safe, even with people, if he maybe bumps someone.
Yeah.
Also, we have, as I said, because they are custom drones. They look like they are not, but they are really, really safe. We have just one switch specifically to turn off the motors, which is really important. If we can talk a little bit about the DJI Mavic that you can buy everywhere, which are really amazing, really safe. They have so many sensors, GPS, so many safety features. But let's be honest, if you want to turn off quickly the motors of those drones, you cannot.
No. Well, you can, but it's really dangerous sometimes.
It takes a few seconds if you do some specific joystick stuff.
Yeah.
It takes maybe 2, 3, 4 seconds.
And there are a few settings that you can do that.
Yeah.
I honestly never tried.
No.
I'm always scared to do this.
Yeah.
Can imagine that you pretty much like use the controller and by mistake and turn off the motors.
Yeah.
But I think that's something that we can discuss and bring and deep dive, pretty much like go deep on this kind of subject.
Yeah.
The main thing for this podcast today was give like this groundbreaking news, and we are super happy.
Yeah.
It's been like 5 months that we are trying to do this. Was not that easy.
No, but we got it.
But at the end, we got it.
Yeah.
And thank you so much for everything, and especially Franco and everything that we have done. It's definitely something that we are pursuing. We got it, and now it's up to us to show to you guys what we can do better and provide better service for you.
Yeah. Stay tuned, Sky Perth Talk. Let's see you in the next one, right? Thank you so much. Congratulations.
See you next time.
Thank you.
Yes, it was.
We did it. See ya.
Incredible. Hey, I think it was something to pursue, and we lost a few projects.
Yeah.
We did like tests and it's kind of a relief that we got it. We can wait to show all the results and show all the possibilities, everything that we're going to be doing.
We are ready. So
how about you, Frank? Are you ready?
I am ready. My drones are ready since like 3 years ago. We have so many drones. We are so ready to do these cinewhoops, chasing drones to do some fast shots.
Let's wait to show this on the next episode.
Yeah.
See you next time.
Bye.
Oh, I put the camera wrong. I was farther than me and it was supposed to be you. Good, man. Stop with 1, 2, 3.